Hi, John. We've had a request from Gabriel Pollard, who's a citizen journalist, to do an email interview with you about your video blogging. But we thought you suggested doing a video response rather than emailing her. So I'm going to ask you the questions and on Gabrielle's behalf. And so, Gabrielle, you have to excuse my voice in there as well. So Gabrielle's first question is, John, you produce a video blog or vlog. What got you started?
Hi, Gabrielle. Well, thanks for the opportunity to answer some of your questions. We thought it was firstly a way to adopt modern technology in a fast-paced world where we like to explain some things that are going on. We've got a few forms of being able to communicate. Obviously, the mainstream media is currently the way we do that. But we also produce our own information primarily in the written form. We kind of think that for a lot of people in the busy world, they won't necessarily have time to read that. And so a short video blog is an opportunity to get a more in-depth understanding of what we're thinking, for us to explain a little bit further, but also to do it in a forum, which is easy, quick, and people feel they have a little bit of an insight. So it's I think, a great technique, and from the results we're getting so far, it's working really well.
Cool, and I think that covers off Gabrielle's second question, which is why participate in it. So I'll move on to Gabrielle's third question, which is, do you see it as a way of communicating with the public or a one-way path for you to get your views out? Do you read and respond to comments on your site?
Well, it's definitely a two-way street, and that's why we label the site Join the Conversation. I certainly do look at the messages being posted on the site, and we've now got a new part of it, which is John Responds. Actually, it's been very interesting. What's been going on our site matches up with what we see with other public information that we get. It's a mirror image, actually, of the emails we receive or the letters I get into my office, the phone calls we receive around the country. So it's just another communication device, but it very much mirrors what we see, but very instant. And where it's been topical, and things like Section 59 smacking, we've had a lot of response to that, and it's worked really well.
John, you've often posted video responses rather than writing on the site. Is that because you find it quicker and more convenient as well?
Yeah, I mean, the whole purpose of this is to sort of give people a little insight, if you like, about what we're thinking and why we're thinking it. Now, we can obviously write that down, but it takes a while for people to digest it. You don't get the sort of intonation. You can't see the whites of our eyes. I just think it's a great opportunity for us to explain what we're thinking in hopefully plain English and to give a sense of how we reach the decision. I think for a lot of people, they see the decision in the paper, or they hear about it over the radio, or they hear the headline of the policy. What people are looking for when they go searching on our site, I think, is a sense of how we reached it, what factors we considered, maybe why we rejected some other things, and what it is that led us to the final conclusion that we've made. And so in that regard, I think it's a very important form, and that's why I think it'll be more and more popular as a form of communicating on a two-way street with politicians and the public.
So you're going to keep posting video responses to people's comments? You want to keep the conversation going?
For sure, we want to keep the conversation going. And it's interesting, on the public sites, things like YouTube, we're picking up more and more responses there without even our direct site. We're trying to now cross-pollinate, if you like, and through the various different newsletters that other MPs have, push people towards our site. Yeah, every letter I write now has an indication, maybe come and have a look at the site. So we think that's the future. If you go and have a look at the US presidential election, the two main Democratic nominations, Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton, both launched their application to become, or their presidential nomination, through a website. And I think that gives you an indication of just how powerful they think the internet is. And we would certainly agree with them. We think it's a very powerful medium and one that will increase over time.
Do you feel, Gabrielle's next question is, do you feel that as a young and fresh national leader you can relate to the younger generation through vlogging while appealing to the traditional national support base through use of this technology?
Well, interestingly enough, we originally thought this would be a device mainly for younger voters. We thought that they would, they're obviously early adopters of the technology, very used to it. I look at my own children, they never go to the paper to see what's on at the movies these days. They just log into the site and they do that for everything they want. But what has been really fascinating is the number of more mature voters who are starting to use this, both the internet actually, but also as a form of listening to what we have to say and communicating with us. So it's right across the age spectrum now. As I said, it's quick and it's easy and it's convenient. It's something you can put up after a minute and a half. You have a much greater sense of where we're going. And I think a sense of intimacy, and that's why we've tried to run some different videos. We've got the one about me at Martatini or me taking a bit of a guided tour around Parliament. It's just an opportunity to see a different side of politics that you don't see in the mainstream media.
And will you be producing more videos during the election year as you and your party are trying to get the public support?
For sure. I mean, we see this as a very important technique during the election. As people's interest heightens, as it always does around election time, I think you'll increasingly see people go to our site and view our video blogs, and we'll be very keen to see the responses we're getting, particularly as we outline very specific policy. We've done that already in education or in areas like charitable giving, economic development. We've seen quite a lot of responses from the public, and that only heightens as you get into an election campaign.
John, you also participate in the online photo sharing site Flickr. Where can you see this form of online media taking you?
Well, I think it's pretty important. We use Flickr at the moment because it's we think the superior technology. There's all sorts of community sharing devices on that. We haven't gone down that pathway yet, but we do see it as an important technology, and we're happy to be part of it.
Will you be in the future looking at other forms of online media to take part in, such as live chats with the public or streaming what you're doing?
I like the ideas of that, and I like the idea of that in government. I think there's a real capacity actually for a different minister a week to be online for an hour or a couple of hours. Again, it's a great way of communicating right across New Zealand. It's environmentally friendly, in other ways, in a plane. But it is an opportunity for people to engage with you, as long as they feel very confident that you're the person on the other end. One of the things about the when it's just in a written form, a sort of blog, if you like, is that you can't be sure that it's the actual politician sitting at the other end. So we quite like the idea of a Skype sort of video conference type argument where anyone could dial up, anyone can ask questions. We have to have some sort of order of semblance so you don't have 10,000 people asking a question at the same time. But I think it can work, and I think increasingly, again, it can become a quite powerful way of communicating and getting information back. We're obviously in the ability of the position where we have to make decisions and formulate policy, but we really only do that effectively when we have communication the other way. So it's a two-way street.
Thank you, John.
Thanks very much, and thanks, Gabrielle.